Hello students, I welcome you all on behalf of GS College of Commerce, Wardha, and I am your subject teacher for Business Economics and the stream is BCCA 3rd sem. In previous lectures, we have seen the law of supply, every detail regarding supply. What is supply? What is the meaning of supply? Concept of supply, along with that, statement of supply, and most importantly, the supply curve along with its schedule. So I hope these things are clear for you. Now, in yesterday's lecture, we have seen, in the last lecture, we have gone through with the exception of law of supply. What are the assumptions? And along with the assumptions, exceptions of law of supply. Now, after studying the law in detail, along with the curve and along with the schedule, exceptions, assumptions. See, in the exam, if the question is like, explain the law of supply, and that question is for 16 marks, okay, in that case you have to write each and every detail. First of all, you will start your answer with introduction, then you will write the concept in short, then you will attempt for the statement of law, give the heading in inverted commas, okay, and then underline those things, whatever the topic you are discussing or whatever the topic you are exploring, and then write your answer, okay. After writing the statement of law, come to the schedule of the curve. Along with the schedule, the very next will be your curve, supply curve, okay. After that, you attempt for the assumptions, and lastly you will write exceptions. What are the assumptions and exceptions of law of supply? Now, this is what is in detail we have seen all in our earlier lectures. But now, today we will move on to elasticity of supply. In earlier lectures, we have also gone through the same with reference to demand. What is elasticity of demand? So, exactly what is elasticity? You know the meaning of elastic. In simple words, elastic means the thing or a particular, that thing which you can stretch up to one limit, okay, that elastic you can stretch up to one limit. Here, now with reference to the economics, what is elasticity of supply? Now, elasticity of supply explains the quantitative change, but what kind of change? It is the quantitative change in the supply of the commodity. What is that? It is the change. But which kind of change? It is a quantitative change in the supply of a commodity. Obviously, because we are discussing about the elasticity of supply, that change will be in supply. But what kind of change? It is a quantitative change in the supply of a commodity due to given change in the price of the commodity. Here you will find that two terms are very important. That is change. Change in what? Change in supply in accordance with change in price of the commodity. Okay, this is change and change in supply. But what kind of supply? Quantitative change in supply with reference to or supply of a commodity due to the. Why that change is taking place or why there is a change? Because given change in a price of a commodity. See, these two lines explains everything about the elasticity of supply. Again, we will see. Elasticity of supply means a quantitative change in the supply. When the supply is changed by the supplier, depending upon the prices of the commodity which he is selling in the market. Okay, again, the quantity he is going to change. The seller will concentrate on the quantity regarding the change in the price of a commodity. Very simple. What you need to understand is elasticity of supply means a quantitative change in the supply of a commodity due to the given change in the price of the commodity. Okay, this is what is the meaning of elasticity of supply. Now again we will see, elasticity of supply is defined as a ratio of percentage change. Now again, it is a technical term. Whenever we draw a formula or we explain the things with the help of this formulas, it means it has got a technical importance, and that is why it is a technical term. So elasticity of supply is defined as the ratio of percentage change in the quantity or the proportionate change in the quantity supplied to the percentage change or a proportionate change in the price. Again, the meaning of the two, the concept is same, A and A. Both the meaning is same. Here we have seen that it explains the quantitative change in the supply of a commodity due to the given change in the price of the commodity. Again, what it means? What is the meaning of elasticity of supply? Elasticity of supply is defined as a ratio of percentage change, because it is a technical term. So when we talk in technical terms or we explain the things technically, then the things should be very exact and perfect. That is why a percentage is taken. So percentage change in the quantity or the proportionate change in the quantity supplied to the percentage change or the proportionate change in the price. Again, change in the supply with reference to the change in price. So how the supply is done or how the supply is processed in the market by the supplier, it depends on the price of the commodity, the given price of the commodity. Okay, now the same thing, or as we have said, it is a technical term. Now the same thing is explained with the help of formula. Now what is that formula? In last with reference to the elasticity of demand, we have seen it is a technical term. It is a response towards the change in the price related with the commodity. Likewise, the things are similar with supply also. Okay, what you need to understand is only in case of law of demand, it is a consumer, and here the main person is supplier who is supplying the commodity, and he will think from the market situations or the conditions in the market regarding the supply of the commodity. How much total quantity he is available with him, how much total stock he is having, and accordingly considering the changes, quantitative change in the supply, and when he will made that quantitative change in supply, that a commodity due to the given change in the price, when there is a change in the price in the market, considering that situation, considering those circumstances, the supplier will make some changes, and that is exactly is known as elasticity. Okay, as we have seen, the total stock is the source for supply. क्या है ये? Total stock is the source of supply. This is very important. So he is not going to sell his complete stock in the market. He will see the situation, the circumstances in the market. When the prices are higher, he will sell his product more and more. He will put his more stock in the market, and then only he will try to incur more and more profit. For example, as he have the producer has produced 2000 kgs of a rice, and the total 2000 kgs of a rice he is not going to sell in the market in one stroke. He will consider the market, he will see how the rates of the other competitors they are selling in the market, and accordingly he will take his decision for that total stock, and then only he will sell his product, his commodity in the market. So total stock is the source for the supply. Always remember, what is that? Total stock is the main source for the supply. And who is supplying? The supplier or a producer is supplying in the market. And what he will see? Obviously, the maximum profit to be earned. Okay, and to earn that maximum profit, again what he will study or what he will analyze? How the products are moving in the market, how the other people like him who are selling the products in the market, what are the rates of those suppliers. And as and when he comes to know that the prices of the certain products are increasing, then he will limit his stock. Okay, and when the prices are higher, he will introduce, he will sell more and more goods of a commodity which he is producing in the market. This is the simple law of supply. So total stock is the source for the supply. Now we will see the formula. What is that formula? Elasticity of supply is percentage change in the quantity supplied divided by percentage change in the price. Or the formula may be drawn with two options: either percentage change in quantity supplied divided by percentage change in the price, or change in the quantity divided by existing quantity, or change into existing price divided by change in a price. Now we will see here. ES stands for price elasticity of supply. Which kind of elasticity? Price elasticity. As we have seen, there are three kinds of elasticity: price elasticity, income elasticity, and unit elasticity. But here we need to understand the price elasticity of supply, because price is the main component, price is the main factor which is determined while supplying the product, supplying the commodities in the market. So price elasticity of supply, then this is called quantity, change in quantity supplied. Okay, this symbol stands for change in a quantity supplied. Then Q is original quantity, P is original, or we can say existing quantity, P is a original price, and then change in price. This symbol stands for change in price. So you have to see, or you have to deal with only up to the formulas. You don't need to make any calculations. But if there is a question on elasticity of supply, then you must cover all the things: the meaning, the introduction, the concept of elasticity of supply, at the same time the formula of elasticity of supply, that you must cover. So this is the formula, that is change in the quantity supplied, percentage change in the quantity supplied divided by percentage change in the price, or change in a quantity divided by quantity into price, original price, existing price divided by change in a price. Now why we have taken here a percentage? Because elasticity of supply is a ratio of percentage change. And why ratio? Because it is a technical term. So per ratio of a percentage change in the quantity, or the proportionate change in the quantity supplied to the percentage change in the proportionate change of in the price of the commodity. Price, this is for the commodity price. Okay, so this is the meaning of elasticity of supply. Again, we will just go through, repeat the things. What is elasticity of supply? Elasticity of supply explains the quantitative change. This is important. Which kind of change? Quantitative change in the supply of a commodity. Okay, where the change is happening? Change in supply. And what kind of change? A quantitative change in the supply of a commodity due to the given change in the price of the commodity. Okay, when the price of a certain commodity changes with reference to that, so elasticity is referred as a quantitative change in the supply of a commodity. Now who is making those quantitative changes? The supplier is changing. Okay, now how he will change? Considering the given change in the price of the commodity. Okay, I hope this definition is clear for you. So elasticity of supply is defined as the ratio of percentage change in the quantity, or proportionate change in the quantity supplied to the percentage change, or a proportionate change in the price. So how these changes are taking place, that we have exactly drawn with the help of formula. And this formula is very important. You should write the formula in the exam if there is a question on elasticity of supply. So total stock is the main source for the supply. What is total stock? The quantity the supplier or a producer has produced, that is his total stock. Now considering the situations in the market, or after doing the surveys in the market, he will see what are the rates, what are the prices of the commodity, how those are changing the prices in the market, and considering those change in the price, the supplier will sell his product in the market. He will look from his maximum profit point of view, and then only he will sell his product, sell his commodities in the market. So this is how is elasticity of supply. In the next lecture we will see the different types of elasticity of supply, and those different types are very similar to the different types of elasticity of demand. Okay, but still in the next lecture we will see the different types of elasticity of supply. By the time, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.